Welcome to new Sailfish OS podcast. And like I promised, I want to show you Sailfish Secrets, which is a new secret store UI and management software for Sailfish OS. And it's in a very, very early version right now, but I will show you and go through the things that are implemented, and we can, I think, speculate a little bit about what will the future hold for these new Sailfish secrets application or framework. So first of all, how do you install this on your Sailfish OS 2.2 device? It's an early version, like I said, but it's already available in the repositories. You need to open up a terminal, SSH, to your device, and then you can just simply install the Sailfish Secrets minus UI package. Sailfish Secrets in general is not found for some very strange reason. As you can see here above, the terminal search was successful, and you can see that there's a Sailfish Secrets package, but it's not installable. So I installed Sailfish Secrets minus UI, and this will simply install a lot of things that allow you to encrypt stuff or sign stuff. And after the installation is finished, you can just simply go to the settings application, and under the new category security, you can find the keys option, which will bring you to a new page which allows you to set a master lock code. I'm not sure what this master lock code is, because if I click on it, it will just simply ask what I want to do, what's the old master lock key, if I want to change the key code. But I never entered a key code before, so I'm not sure what code it's asking for. It's not the PIN code that I set up here on this device. I think it isn't. No, incorrect. Passphrase, try again. This is what I get here, the little notification that disappears. So I'm not sure what this master lock code is, but apparently this should be an additional thing, or it should be the master to sign or encrypt all the stuff. I'm not sure what it's really doing. What you can do is, in the UI, you can generate a new key, which will allow you to simply set up. First of all, you have the option to choose a key name. In this case, we'll do a test key. And you can choose between the key type, RSA, and elliptic curve. I use RSA here, which it's the default. And it will then ask for a passphrase. And then you give it a passphrase, simple one in this case. And what you can do now is simply nothing. You can remove the key if you want to, but this is everything you can do in this UI. What you can do then in the system itself with this signed or this newly created key is, apparently the idea behind it is that you can simply from every application that supports the share functionality under Sailfish OS, you can just simply hit the share button, and there you will find, just like for example in the gallery app, you can find a new entry called sign, and this should allow you either to encrypt the file, which would be very nice, or sign the file somehow. But if you click on it, it will show you the file, it will show you the megabytes of the file as well, and it will show you all your keys. And you can click on one of those keys, and it starts apparently signing or encrypting this file, I'm sure, and then opens up or switches to the email application to write a new email. But for some strange reason, as you can see here, there is no attachment at all attached to the email itself. So if I just enter any data in here and send the email, I only get the empty email without any signed file or encrypted file. So I'm not sure what this is supposed to do here. But what I can imagine what will be in the future in here is either that it will attach the file directly as an encrypted file, or it will attach the file together with a sign key, so that whoever you send the key, the email to, will receive not only the email but also the attachment together with your signature, and he can or she can then check the signature and see that this email is unique, that this email is apparently really from you and not from some man in the middle attack or something like this. Those are the ideas that I basically have for this new system, Safefish Secrets. But I like to say Safefish Secure, but Safefish Secure is something completely different. And I think in one of the earlier videos I mentioned Safefish Secure. Safefish Secure is this collaboration of Yola with SSH together to bring out a very secure smartphone. And this is something completely different. So Safefish Secrets is just an UI for, I think, signing and encrypting files. The cool thing is that it looks like that it will have some sort of access list for applications to access the Safefish Secrets store. So maybe it's trying to be something like on Linux with KGPG or KWallet, if you know it, or on the GNOME world, how it's called, the GNOME password store or something like this. So maybe it's trying to be something like this together with encryption and signing options, but I'm not so sure yet. It's in very early version right now, and we will see how it will develop in the next versions. I'm not sure if the next version 2.2.1 will have some improvements, or we will see a big new improvement and the final application with Safefish OS 3.0. But it's a good thing that they are working on such an application that allows you to secure more stuff on your device, and especially now with the fingerprint support available, you can use your thumb or your finger prints basically to lock or unlock files, to sign files and documents, to encrypt files and documents, which would be nice, very nice addition, I think, to Safefish OS, especially if you will have the option to just simply encrypt files on your system itself, which is, I think, very important these days. So currently in this form, I cannot show you much, as you saw right now. But I think we will see some improvements in the future. This is everything for this little demonstration about Safefish Secrets. I hope you enjoyed it and thanks for watching. Otherwise, if you have some questions or comments how to use it basically, or if there's a trick how to make it more useful and something I missed basically, just write it in the comments below. Otherwise, give a thumbs up and thanks for watching. Until the next time, bye.